Good morning, students. Today I am here with you with a new poem, "I Mean to Do My Work Today," written by Richard Lee Galin. Okay? So let us see the warm-up session. There are times when we have to work to do and yet we feel like playing. What you do during such time? Now if you will consider, according to me, if it is too tempting, I go out and play. So now let us see the poem. "I mean to do my work today, but a brown bird sang in the apple tree, and a butterfly flitted across the field, and all the leaves were calling me, and the wind went sizzling over the land, tossing the grasses to and fro, and a rainbow held out its shining hand, and so could I do but laugh and go." So here the speaker, who is the speaker here? The speaker is you can consider a small child. Okay, it may be a he or it may be a she. Now, speaker want to do his or her work that day. But the brown bird, the rainbow, the butterfly, the wind and the leaves all stopped him or her to doing the work. Okay, the child would be more tempting to get distracted by these outside things. Okay, children? So, what the speaker say? The speaker want to do all his work that day. But a brown bird sang in the apple and a butterfly flitted. Flitted means move freely across the field. And all the leaves were calling him. And the wind went sizzling over the land. Sizzling over the land means moving noisily, okay? And the wind went sizzling over the land, tossing the grass. Now when the wind blow, what happened? There is a tall grasses, they move from one side to another side one direction and to the other direction. That is number of time. And a rainbow held out his shining hand. So who is coming out? The rainbow. So what could I do but laugh and go? So here the child would be more tempted to get distracted by this outside thing. So what he decided? To leave his work, to stop his work and to go outside and enjoy the nature. Okay, children? So you might have understood the poem. So let us do the grammar part. Before grammar part, so student, you might have understood the poem. So let us see how many things work together to stop the speaker from doing his or her work. Complete the table to show that what they were and what they did. Things, what they did. Brown bird sang in the apple tree. Butterfly flitted across the field. Leaves calling the child. Wind sizzling. Rainbow held out a shining hand. So student, you might have understood the poem very well. Okay? You might have understood the poem very well. So have a good day. Thank you.